Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I know I've missed a couple of days. I was supposed to stuff my full-time income, but I'm back and I'm ready to continue my budgeting journey. Please ignore my nails. I had to take off my long nails because I went to Amazon earlier in the day. And actually in this video, I want to post a clip of me, I guess like a day in the life of me working at Amazon. Like, I know I do these side income stuffings, but it's cool to get a visual on how I actually earn my side income. So I will be inserting that in this video. And if you're not interested, I will put a timestamp where we can skip directly to the stuffing. But if you are interested, you guys will be coming along with me to my overnight job. So that'd be fun. Okay, y'all, I got y'all sitting in the passenger seat, and I'm about to go to Starbucks because...
Starbucks,
okay,
sorry for you.
Hi, can I get a tall cold brew? A tall pumpkin cold brew?
Right, it's gonna be $4.51.
Thank you. So anyways, y'all, I got y'all in the passenger seat, and I'm about to get some Starbucks. I got a cold brew, and if you know, a cold brew is basically the Hennessy of Starbucks. I need that because I'm gonna be working for a long time. My shift is actually from 9 to 6:30 a.m. 9 p.m. to 6:30 a.m. So I need to stay awake for sure. Y'all, look at her. She's beautiful. She's gonna help me stay awake tonight. I'm literally on break right now, and it is 1:33 in the morning, and yes, I am super tired, but I still have until 6:30, so I got like 5 more hours left to go. And yeah, this is usually what happens. We get a little 30-minute break and then we have to go back. For breaks, I always sit in my car. Like, I'm the type of person, I've seen my coworkers for 4 hours. I do not want to see you during my break. Like, I'm sorry. I need my space. I need to zone out. I need to be comfortable. So I always spend my breaks in my car. Like, and a lot of other people do too. As you can see, it's a little packed out here. So. I also forgot to mention that I'm actually a stower. So basically, you take the item out of the bin and you put it in the pod. It's like a robot. And they just go back and they come back and come back. I don't know, I'm blabbering right now, but it's a robot pod thing, and it goes and stores items, so that way basically the packer, well, the picker can get it, and then the packer will pack it. So I know that made absolutely no sense. You probably don't care, but I just told you anyway. So if you ever want to work at Amazon, just think about what I just told you. Honestly, I feel like this job isn't sustainable long term. Like, right now my goal is to work 20 hours a week, but doing that, I know, like, my debt is going to take me at least 3+ years to pay off. Like, I just know that. I mean, let me not say that, anything can happen, but going at the pace that I'm planning on going, it'll probably take 3+ years. And if I'm doing 20 hours a week here on top of my full-time job, I'm gonna look like a raisin. Like, I am not gonna be looking good out here. I ain't gonna be beauty in the budget. It's gonna be ugly in the budget, and that's not cute. Like, I know, like, I really just want to start a business and maybe pick up hours here and there, not do 20 hours, maybe 4 hours. I could do that, but yeah, that's definitely a goal I want to focus on in 2022, is to definitely find other streams of income, because there's so many ways to make money out here. Like, you guys see, especially since the pandemic, like, there's really no excuse. Like, I can definitely find another side hustle that's not as physically demanding. But I mean, I'm not being ungrateful. I'm very blessed to have this job, so
like I always say, I'm gonna turn water into wine, and we're gonna get there.
It's 3:40 and I'm still hanging in there. Barely. I almost forgot to close out the vlog, but I made it 6:32. And honestly, y'all, like, I have a second wind. Like, I think it's that coffee, that cold brew is no freaking joke. I'm still awake, but I know as soon as I get home, I'm gonna crash, so. Yeah. I actually have to log in at 9 a.m., so I usually take a nap at 7 until, like, 8:50, so, like, an hour and a half nap. Yeah, that's pretty much that. This overnight shift, overnight life, vamp life, whatever you want to call it, that is what I do to earn my side income for now. Like I said, for now. But I am on my way home and I'm about to take a little nap. I don't eat breakfast really, so my first meal is usually lunch. Honestly, at this point, as soon as I get off, I just want to eat, sleep. Like, there's really nothing else I'm going to do but sleep. And I will be logging in at 9 a.m. on my laptop because I do telework until 5:30 p.m. The next time I work, I might try this again, but of course a little bit better. I was just like a little nervous showing my, I guess, recording. I don't know. My fulfillment center is actually really small, so it's like everybody knows everybody. Everybody sees everything. You know, you can't really mind your business at times, but I try my best. And that's that. So I'll see you guys later. Bye, guys. So this is my last paycheck for the month of November in terms of my side income. So last week I did work 20 hours, so I did meet my goal. And I got paid $280. Now, this amount is kind of low to me, but we do have differentials. So if you work, you know, around a certain time frame, we got a differential. But to my understanding, that's over now until Christmas. So this amount did drop. It definitely would have been well over $300, but you know, it is what it is. Yeah. Politics, right? But, you know, I'm going to make do with what I have, and I'm going to go ahead and stuff it. So, as you can see, I did divide this between everything already. I did this off camera. Pretty much, I do a zero-based budget, so whatever I get paid from my part-time job, I give every dollar a name, pretty much. And you can see that here. So, I'm going to go ahead and grab my cash, and I am going to stuff these envelopes. So I'm going to go ahead and count just to make sure that the amount we have is correct. So we have 50, 100, 20, 40, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, so 200, 10, 20, 30, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80. So this is correct. I have 280, and I'm gonna go ahead and lay that out for you guys. I'm actually gonna try to make them all face the same way because I rewatched some of my old videos and I cringe because it's like, oh my gosh, like, girl, why are you so unorganized? Make this look cute. Come on now. So I'm gonna try to make everything look uniform today. Okay, so there's that. And my old binder actually broke, like the magnetic part actually broke. So I put all my cash envelopes inside here for now. I need to buy a new one, but for now everything's gonna be in here. I mean, which is fine. Okay, so my first category is car maintenance. So we're gonna give that $10. So let's go ahead and add that. And of course, as always, I always fill out my trackers prior. So now my car maintenance has 100, 50, 70, 180. So I have $180 in car maintenance.
which is good. And now I have my gifts. What's gifts getting? Gifts is getting $20. So I'm gonna pull out a 20, and my gifts envelope is actually for Christmas and birthdays. So yeah, we penny pinching this year, but it's okay, you know, we gotta do what we gotta do. So gifts has 50, 100, 20, 130, 131, 132, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now I have $137. Next, I have insurance. And let's pull that out. So this week, insurance will be getting... Actually, I think I'm going to do 210. No, I'll keep it like that. Insurance is going to be getting $40. So you can add that to this. And this is just me saving up so that way I can pay my insurance in full for the next 6 months next year. So let's see what we have. 50, 100, 150, 170, 190, 210, 230, 250, 270, 290, 300, 31, 32, 303. So I have $303, and my goal is actually $500. Now, if I can do more, that's great, but that's just a goal that I have, just so I don't overwhelm myself. And so far, I'm on track to do that before the end of the year. So small wins. Alrighty, next I have health, and health will be getting $10. So we can pull out a 10. Okay, add that. So now health has 50, 70, 90, 100, 110. And I'll probably be using this soon too. Definitely in January. I have a few appointments coming up, so we'll enjoy that number while we can. Next, I have vacation, which is growing slowly. And vacation is getting $20, so I'll do 210s. Alrighty. Oops. Let's move this over, actually. So vacation has 20, 40, 60, 81, 10, 20, 30, 35, 40, 41. So I have $141 in vacation. My personal envelope comes from my side income, of course. Usually this is all this money is coming from my side income, because as y'all saw, I slaved to make this money. So I gotta pay myself a little something. So this week I did give myself $15. So I'm going to go ahead and add that to what we already have. Okay. So now my personal envelope has 50, 70, 90, 110, 120, 130, 140, 145, 146, 7, and 8. So I have $148. I was thinking about it, honestly. Getting cold outside, and I kind of want to get these Uggs that I've been eyeing, but they're like $179. So yeah, I'm gonna have to add that to my Christmas list or just stuff more here. So yeah, we'll see about that. Next, I have housing, which is my apartment for my apartment for 2023, when I plan to move out of my current apartment. And that is only getting $5. I'm slowly building this up, but of course, once that time is closer, I'm gonna stuff way more. But right now, I have 20, 25, 30, 35, 36, 37. So basically enough for an application fee, if you wanna think on the positive side. And next, I have my side hustles. This envelope is very near and dear to my heart, because this envelope will help me not have to work as many hours at Amazon. My goal is to start an Etsy shop, so this envelope will be getting $30, and I'm a little scared. Hopefully I have enough change. I'm a little nervous. Okay, well, I'm just gonna do 2 10s and 2 5s, and hopefully that works out as far as a change. So now I have 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 75, 80, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90. Ooh, I got $90 in here. That's exciting. Really? Yeah, I do. Okay. My goal for this envelope is really like $300. But yeah, I'm excited about this. I definitely want to post my Etsy shop next year. It's going to take some time. Maybe earlier. I don't know. We'll see. It's just going to be a goal of mine. And next we have, I keep doing that. Next we have giving, and that is getting $2. Because we always want to give back. So now that has 20, 25, 26, 27. This is just an ugly dollar. Actually, all these bills are kind of ugly. But hey, if you need it, you'll appreciate it, okay? A dollar is a dollar. And my entertainment envelope will be getting $3. So I have three here. And I need to stop doing that. I have, okay, add this. So now for entertainment, I have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And with this, I do have plans this weekend to go ice skating, but it's like I don't have to pay for it, let's put it that way. But just in case you want to get, like, I don't know, snacks or something, maybe I can treat, you never know, with my little $15, $18, however much I have in here, it's something. Okay, now my emergency fund. I'm going to post about this in my next video. My next video is going to be my debt payoff, because I didn't film my full-time income, but this is actually my last debt snowball payment, and next month I will have three paychecks. So I have plans for this. I definitely want to boost up my emergency fund to $1,000 at least, and I'm going to be showing you guys how I plan to do that. All right, next is the beast itself, the good old 10K challenge. So today I will be contributing $60. Okay, and pull this out. And I'm going to grab a 50. I'm going to grab my last 10. So, now my 10K challenge has 100, 200, 300, 400, 450, 460, 470, 480, 45, 490, 495, 500, 501, 502, and 503. Oh, this is just so satisfying. Like I said in my last video, this is money that, you know, I slaved over. So just to know that I saved $500 from my part-time, that feels so good. And lastly, the biggest beast of them all is the debt snowball. So we are going to pull this out, and I am going to be adding $65 to my debt snowball. So there's that, add that. So let's go ahead and count our debt snowball total for the month of November. 50, 100, 50, 70, 90, 210, 230, 250, 270, 290, 300, 305, 10, 15, 20. So I have $320 in here, and this is going straight to my biggest credit card, and that's part of the surprise. So
My debt snowball is actually a lot smaller than usual, and I will explain that in my next video, which will probably be right after this one, so I'm gonna film that. And we're gonna pay off some debt, y'all. Like, we are making this happen, okay? We are making this happen. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you so much for subscribing and just viewing my content. If you're interested, like I said, I will be posting a video right after this about my debt update, so you guys will see my total debt that I did have and how much I paid off for the past month and how much I paid off in total for the past 2 months. So if you're interested, stay tuned. Feel free to subscribe, you know, join the family. We are coming up, we're getting deep out here. So yeah, I hope you guys have a great holiday, a great Thanksgiving, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.